Claire, and today I will show you a video I made about the ancient Egyptians. Let us travel back 5,543 years ago to Egypt. Ancient Egypt was located along the lower regions of the Nile River. The timeline of ancient Egypt was from 3,500 BC to 32 BC. Remember that now. I will show you the clothes of the Egyptians. Most children went around completely naked until the age of 6. By the time they grew up, men would wear a loincloth, short kilt, and a type of shirt. Women would wear a dress with one shoulder strap only. The food of the ancient Egyptians was interesting. They got most of their food from the Nile River and its banks. They would grow crops on the river's fertile banks and fish for meat. Some of their recipes included bread with honey. Whoa, Anubis, Bastet, I thought you guys weren't coming until we hit 3,800 BC.
Gods and goddesses can do whatever they want, so we thought we'd come early.
She forced me to.
Did not.
Did too.
Stop the argument! Since you guys came early, we are going to do the religion underworld skip. Anubis, come with me.
Fine.
Please enjoy this dance while we wait for the skip.
He's dead! Now we can meet him in the underworld!
To get into the afterlife, the deceased must pass some tests. The first one is that he goes to the king of the dead and gets accused of all the bad things he has done. Then he is led to another god who writes the deeds on his soul. Then the hard part starts.
The scale of truth.
You would be led to Anubis, who would take your soul and measure it against a feather representing Mat, the god of justice.
The feather, the feather, the feather! Oh, wait, that's not it. Feather, 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 the feather! Here we go!
Where am I?
You're in the underworld! Like it?
Not really.
Well, just give me your heart. The moment of truth.
See, his heart is heavy with bad deeds. He shall be punished!
Devourer of the dead, show yourself!
Roar!
I'll never get bored of that.
If he was good, I wouldn't hurt him. He'd go to the afterlife. He'd still work, though. He'd work in happiness. No bad, bad.
Yes, the afterlife is exactly like that on Earth. But they arrive in a boat, and they work with joy. It's not hard at all. However, you had to be mummified to go to the afterlife. They believed that because they thought you would have to have your heart preserved to be weighed.
Let us introduce you to some of the gods. You know me already. I'm the Devourer of the Dead. This is Anubis. In the measuring of the part, he always lends a helping hand. This is Bastet, the cat goddess.
Meow.
She was originally thought to be the Eye of Ra, a fierce protector that was tricked with blood-colored wine that put her to sleep and end her evilness.
Okay, please stop this. Can we move on? You're freaking me out.
No, there are even more gods. There's Osiris, Nut, Bes, Geb, and many, 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 many more that I can't even talk about them all.
Now can we go?
Fine, off we go. Let's go!
Move it!
Random dancing! Rich. They would go to a school called Scribal School in hopes that they would enter the royal service someday. If they didn't want to, like that would ever happen, they could become an apprentice. For example, if you wanted to become a doctor, you would become a doctor's apprentice and work for him or her. The houses of the ancient Egyptians were usually made of sun or kiln-baked mud and straw bricks. Rich people could have more than one room and have their walls painted. Poor people would only have one room and no furniture. They would sleep on the floor with a tiny headrest to keep away from scorpions. The Egyptian's government and society included the pharaoh, vizier, nobles, priests, scribes, soldiers, craftsmen, farmers, and slaves. Pharaoh was the king and had to keep the gods happy, protect Egypt, make laws, and keep order. He or she was considered more than a mortal human, but a god, him or herself. The vizier was the pharaoh's chief advisor and was sometimes also the high priest. He had to settle disputes between nobles, protect Pharaoh's household, be responsible for the supply of food, oversee administration, and all documents had to have his sign of approval. Nobles ruled the regions of Egypt called nomes. They had to make local laws and keep order in their region. Priests had to keep the gods happy and did not preach to people. They performed rituals and ceremonies for the god of their temple. Scribes were the only people that learned to read and write. They kept the records of many things, like the number of workers, how many soldiers were in the army, how much food was produced at harvest time, and the number of gifts given to the gods. Soldiers had to defend the country and got to share the riches from captured enemies. They were rewarded with land. Many second sons, even those of the pharaoh, chose to join the army. Craftsmen also worked in workshops and were very skilled. They could be pottery makers, leather workers, sculptors, painters, weavers, jewelry makers, shoemakers, and tailors. They often worked together. Farmers on the land of the pharaoh nobles worked and were given housing, food, and clothes in return. Sometimes they rented land from nobles and paid a percentage of their crop as a rent. Since there were no slaves in ancient Egypt, well, there were, but there were no slave markets or auctions, the slaves were prisoners captured in war. They would be seen in the houses of the pharaoh and nobles, working in mines, quarries, and temples. Back to pharaoh's advisors. This is a story that happened to me while I was visiting Egypt.
Vizier, bring the slave!
Okay. Oh, pharaoh, please! I beg of you! I can do more work, please!
It is your wish to be spared?
Yes! Let my work fall upon my back like a thousand crocodiles from the Nile. Let the crocodiles snap at my face as a sign of my humbleness. Let the other slaves have the pleasure of giving me scars. I'll be the most humble slave. Just spare me.
Vizier, come here. Look to the skies. What shall we do?
Spare her for now.
So it is settled. You shall be spared. Leave us! Bring in the second slave.
Oh, please! Oh, please! Let me show you my glorious humbleness.
Pathetic. Take her away and do not spare her. Been looking forward to that.
Games and money news update! The Egyptians would play games related to leapfrog, senet, a lot like backgammon, play music and hang out in the garden, swim, and lots of other things we could do too. There are so many things that they did. Did you know that one Egyptian pound is equal to 0.164442555 of our Canadian dollar?
I would like to give you this Egyptian pound for that stuffed bear.
Are you crazy? That pound isn't even worth 50 cents!
And they didn't have stuffed bears in Egypt.
Whoa! Did you know that the Egyptians contributed written language, architecture, papyrus, and a water-powered clock? Some of the architecture included tombs, pyramids, statues, monuments like the Sphinx, and temples. Before the pharaoh was starting to be buried in pyramids, they were buried in tombs. Some of the architecture is being destroyed by vandalism and pollution? Oh no! Temples would stand on columns, but sometimes the temples would be destroyed and only the columns would stand. The slaves did not build the pyramids. It was proven by a burial found near a pyramid. There were mummies there, and slaves definitely would not have been mummified. Well, that's my presentation.
That sounds great, but why does your cat have a sock on its head?
Huh? What? No. What sock?